And this morning, let's begin by getting you all the updates on what you can expect on day two of the winter session. Yesterday, on day one, we saw, of course, the repealing of the farm laws being passed in the parliament in both houses. There was also the issue of the suspension of opposition MPs. I expect that to resonate in the house today as well. 12 MPs from the Rajya Sabha were suspended for violent behavior during the monsoon session. And a big political showdown looms over that today. Opposition parties will be meeting at 10 this morning to chalk out their strategy and their future course of action. The opposition so far has termed this suspension unfair and unjust. Suspended MPs have alleged that this is being done to ensure that the BJP enjoys a majority in the upper house. The government on its part has said that if suspended MPs seek an apology as per the rules, then they may deliberate on this. A deliberation may be done. The suspension notice says that the MPs should utter disregard to the authority of the chair by persistently abusing the rules of the House. Moreover, it also says that the attacks on the security personnel were also intentional. The suspended MPs include 2 Shiv Sena MPs, including Priyanka Chaturvedi, 6 Congress MPs and 4 CPM MPs.
Leader of Opposition, हमसे और माननीय पीयूष गोयल जी से बात किया, तब भी हम उनको कहा, आप सभी को ये कहिए, वो सदन में माफी मांगे, रिग्रेट व्यक्त करें, अगर वो विषाद व्यक्त करते हैं तो हम मामला इस यही क्लोज करने के लिए, समाप्त करने के लिए हम तैयार हैं।
11th August 2021, Monsoon Session of Parliament. Ruckus broke out in Rajya Sabha during the farm laws debate. The BJP alleged opposition MPs manhandled marshals. The opposition claimed marshals assaulted the protesting MPs. 3 months later, on the very first day of the winter session of parliament, 12 MPs stand suspended for the ruckus in August. The penalised MPs include Priyanka Chaturvedi and Anil Desai of the Shiv Sena.
सीधा आज आकर ये अनाउंसमेंट कर दिया है विदाउट नॉलेज एंड द अंडरस्टैंडिंग इज एंड द एक्सप्लेनेशन इज दैट नोबडी कोऑपरेटेड इन द इन्वेस्टिगेशन आई हैव नॉट एंड आई चैलेंज द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया आई चैलेंज द पार्लियामेंट्री अफेयर्स मिनिस्टर टू शो मी वन सिंगल कॉल दैट दे हैव डन टू मी टू रीच आउट टू मी एंड आस्क मी व्हाट माय वर्जन ऑफ द स्टोरी
द लिस्ट हैज 6 कांग्रेस एमपीज इंक्लूडिंग छाया वर्मा रिपुन बोरा राजमणि पटेल एंड अखिलेश प्रसाद सेन द ग्रैंड ओल्ड पार्टी टर्म द सस्पेंशन डेथ ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी
This is totally undemocratic. This is a murder of the democracy. This is a murder of the constitution. You see, we have not been given the opportunity to be heard. And this is a one-sided decision. It is a biased decision, vindictive decision. Opposition parties have not been consulted here.
The suspension notice said the MPs showed utter disregard to the authority of the chair by persistently abusing the rules of the house. The notice also called the attack on marshals intentional and unprecedented act of misconduct and contempt. While the government stands by its decision calling it a new low, the opposition questions the timing of the suspension.
ड्रामा पिछले सत्र में हुआ था तभी सस्पेंड करना था ये तो कहीं नियम में नहीं लिखा है कि एक सत्र में अगर हंगामा हो तो दूसरे सत्र में उसको सस्पेंड करें
मैंने अपने संसदीय जीवन में इस प्रकार की अराजकता और इस प्रकार का दृश्य नहीं देखा था लेकिन चूंकि उसी दिन सदन स्थगित हो गया तो कार्रवाई करना संभव नहीं था तो ये बहुत स्वागत योग्य कदम है एक संदेश जाना चाहिए उन सांसदों को जो नियम कानून मर्यादा का पालन नहीं करते हैं और जिन्होंने संसदीय परंपराओं को कलंकित करने का काम किया
राज्यसभा चेयरपर्सन वेंकैया नायडू लैश्ड आउट एट द ऑपोजिशन अक्यूजिंग इट ऑफ वेस्टिंग वैल्यूएबल टाइम विद डिसरप्शंस
ऑल द सेक्शंस ऑफ दिस ऑगस्ट हाउस एंडेड अप losers and also the country should we not draw right lessons from such unpleasant experience that entails huge cost to democracy besides leaving a bitter pill in the mouths of the people of our country
the suspension of Rajya Sabha MPs has given the opposition yet another chance to attack the government it well might be an issue that may unite the opposition but will the politics of disruption overtake the business of the house Even in this winter session, remains to be seen. With Paulumi Saha and video journalist Ziauddin, this is Mosmi Singh in Delhi for India Today.
So the suspension of these 12 opposition MPs is going to resonate in the House today and expected to essentially dominate the proceedings. I want to take this across now to our National Affairs Editor, Rahul Srivastava, for more details on this. Rahul, good morning. You know, the opposition, while crying foul here, is maintaining that due procedure wasn't followed. And I want to understand from you, in these kind of circumstances where there's a suspension of members of parliament, what is the procedure to be followed and was it followed in these circumstances?
Good morning, Akshita. You see, when a ruling comes from the chair, usually it is hazardous to debate the issue on whether procedures were followed or not, primarily because, one, the chair has rights, and if he has concurred on a decision, it has been announced by him, to say anything regarding the decision, whether it was just or unjust, is definitely can be construed as breach of privilege. Now, what it was done basically under Rule 256 of Rules of Procedure of Rajya Sabha, how the Rajya Sabha function, under Rule 256, there is a provision that if the chairman names a person, that means a person is named for unruly behavior of any kind, there is a very clear definition on that, the member shall be suspended. Now, what happened is that the incident happened in the last session of the last day, and it could not be taken up, the issue could not be taken up in the monsoon session of Parliament. And what the government felt was that there were actions which required certain action from the chair. Now, the government brought in a motion, and it was allowed by the chair. That means definitely there must have been certain amount of discussion between the chair and the government over the issue. And perhaps one will have to wait and go and see whether the BAC, which is the Business Advisory Committee, in which all proceedings which have to be taken up are also discussed. Now, eventually, the only contest here is won by people like MPs like Priyanka Chaturvedi, one that the rules were not followed. Now, the Rule 256 does allow it. Now, the second element, that it was the action in the last unruly behavior in the last session which has been acted upon in this session. Now, the Rule 256, Part 1, 2, and 3, if you look at one looks at them, it says that a member can be suspended for the remaining period of a session. There is no specification in this rule that a member cannot be suspended for the last session's actions. That means one has to read that gray area between the lines when the lawmakers were talking about creating the rule, that when they said can be suspended for the remaining period of a session, did they mean
all
that
right,
action has to be initiated in the same period? So again, it's a very difficult gray area. But there is also a provision that the suspension can be revoked if the political parties or the government and others do reach an agreement. Now, that's going to happen. One ready to see. Because what we are seeing, one, it has given the opposition something to disrupt more, a reason to disrupt more. Second, what it has done is, it has kind of brought the opposition together because 14 political parties signed it, although Trinamool Congress did not sign it. Two of its members are part of it. The third very important element is, if 12 members remain suspended throughout the term of this session, then remember there are critical bills of the government which are being opposed by all the opposition parties. And in that scenario, opposition will be down by 12 members critically.
All right. We'll see how this plays out in both houses. For the moment, Rahul, thank you very much for joining us with those insights into really how this will play out and how this process really has gone about for the last few months.